My novel is about seven sisters living in the woods, the forest, far, far away from the society. And the inspiration was from a classic novel, a Finnish classic novel with the title Seven Brothers. And it was released 1870, and it was about seven brothers living in the woods, fishing, hunting, talking, fighting, and drink a lot of booze. So I was interested and amused by the idea to see what happens when I put seven sisters in this extremely masculine context. The characters in the novel seem to be like each other. They are kind of raw when they're talking, and they are muscular, and but when you look closer to them, they are kind of differs. They got certain positions in the sisterhood. The elderly ones, they are more like in their bodies. And the younger ones are more soft and like the storytelling and making some figures about things she founds in the woods. So, and I think in this group of sisters, there are positions which we need in a society. We need the intellectuals, we need those who are strong and build houses and cut down trees and so on, which is those who are very strong. So they are needed, all of them, symbolically. One of the ideas was to deal with the struggle between the countryside and the urban life. Which is the best place to live for mankind? Is it in the woods, actually, or is it in the city, where there are libraries and so on, bars and so on? And that question is not very easy, but I found that in movies and in fiction novels, the countryside lose compared to the city. The context is always like, well, if these poor people would go to the city and get a decent job and be a decent member of the society, it will be a relief for them. So it was important for me that these sisters kept on their idea of living the wildlife. It was important for me to write about the this living on the countryside and make it beautiful, although these girls are harsh and they lack of food when it's winter and so on, and they actually are starving. But in the Finnish novel, it's very poetic, and the nature and the environment is very lively and becomes a person, a character in the novel. And I was aiming. I used to like novels where the woods and the lakes are very vivid and got a soul. So that was an idea. When I wrote the book, I was trying to right, realistic in one way, but in the end, it will be like a saga in the wild, not realistic, more mythological. So, and this Alexis Kivi, he was very fond of Shakespeare. So he worked with this very harsh, hard countryside language. The people are living with hard work with their bodies. The Finnish novel by Alexis Kivi was he was got a lot of inspiration from Shakespeare, who loves to create characters from the countryside, which are who are very harsh when they talk and rough, and on the other side create these lyrics about the environment and the plants, birds, lakes, and so on, and make it very sensitive. So I worked a lot with opposites. It was not the main idea to write a feminist novel, but the idea was to examine what happens when I put girls in a masculine context. I noticed while I was writing, when I listened to the news, that more and more often girls and women were caught by the police for fighting. And well, girls are able to, they do violence also. And I think more and more. But we are not used to see that in fiction. And therefore, it was kind of hard to write these scenes when the girls were fighting. Because we are not used to it, it tends to be comic when women fights. In this novel, the city and the places where they live, it doesn't have any name. So it's more, I thought it would be more like mythological. And the woods in Finland, in the north, are very similar to the woods in Sweden. And my ancestors live in the mountains in the north of Sweden. And my grandfather was, he worked in the woods, working class, felling trees. And he loved the woods and the forest, and taught my mother about birds, plants, and taught her to appreciate walking in the woods. And then my mother taught me. So I have a lot of writing in my novels about birds and plants and so on. And sometimes editors tell me that, why don't you just call that bird a woodpecker? And I said, no, I have to be specific because this woodpecker, it's extremely different from this woodpecker. So I'm always eager to be very specific about describing the environment, the animals and plants and so on, the trees. This is the first time a novel that I've written is translated into the French language. And I do enjoy that. I was so surprised when I heard the agency which are selling books abroad in my publishing company, told me this is really French. And because I thought it was the opposite, that maybe countries in like the East, because it's a similar culture, maybe we'll buy it. But I'm so surprised. I'm very happy that my brutal girls took me to Saint-Malo and Paris and France. I'm grateful for them and the French readers.